Okay, so how do you build a topic cluster? I'm going to show you how to do it. You come into Explore by keyword over here, and you put your keyword in here. Let's use a broader keyword, you know, let's use CRM. When we put in CRM, we can see that it has a high difficulty and you need a high domain authority to rank for the keyword. If you already have a high domain authority, great, you can pursue this keyword. If you don't, you're probably going to need to choose a lower keyword for your cluster. If you scroll down here, we can see keyword suggestions, and I'm just going to click view all topics. Now, what this feature does, this feature is called keyword suggestions by topics. And what it does is that it clusters your keyword. And when it clusters your keyword, that means you only need to create the contents at the parent level, at the top of the cluster. And that means you also have a better chance of ranking for those secondary keywords. The topic stream app groups your content by search intent and it's sized by volume. So if I want to pick my topic as an informational keyword, which is most likely going to have a higher search volume, it's just going to show me all of that information. And I can quickly say that, oh, it might be better for me to pursue what is a CRM. So let's click on that. We click what's a CRM, and now we want to use that as a cluster, assuming that we don't have the domain authority to rank for a bigger keyword. And then we click this to see the keyword suggestions for that topic. And now we can see a lot more keywords showing up. I want to filter down by keywords that have a lower difficulty and then export that list. Now, once you've exported your list, it's going to look something like this, at least for the keyword suggestions. You just want to export the topic, the keyword, the monthly search volume and keyword difficulty. And then you bring that into this template that I have given you in the blog post. And you can put in the topic, the keyword, monthly search volume and difficulty. I've created a pivot table that is automatically going to sum up that data. So it's going to pull in all the topics from this spreadsheet and it's going to count them and sum up the monthly volume. So you now have an idea of what is the total monthly volume for each of these topics and the average difficulty. So ideally, you want to pick keywords that have lower monthly difficulty, you know, but still a reasonable search volume as your starting point, and then work your way up from there. And then you put that in your cluster here. Let's assume that monday.com has some content, which they do, as we've seen. So what we're going to do is that they're going to import all of the existing content that they have and put those URLs here. And then you can fill out this, what type of content it is, just to make sure that you don't just have only blog posts or guides. You want to make sure that you have a diversified topic cluster. And next thing, you want to check out the awareness level, just to make sure that your cluster is cohesive and is looking at the entire user journey, not just one part of the user journey. For data like page authority, main ranking keyword and secondary keyword, and even keyword volume, you can pull that in from Moz using the API. And for things like traffic in the last 90 days, you can pull that in by connecting your Google Search Console to the spreadsheet. Yes. And now the main thing is the action. How do you make decisions on your cluster? This is the audit phase. So you have this here that says update. You update when the content is outdated and could do with new information. You know, maybe the search intent for the keyword has changed. You consolidate when you have multiple contents with the same search intent. You know, that causes keyword cannibalization, so it's best to consolidate them. You leave as it is when the content is fresh, it's serving, satisfying the search intent, is performing well, and then you redirect the pages that you've consolidated. If you take all of this content and you put them into your new topic cluster, those old URLs, make sure you redirect them to this new topic clusters. And I don't advise the indexing unless absolutely necessary. And that's it. That is how you build your topic cluster. You want to make sure that your topic cluster has covered all four stages. This is very, very important. You know, top of the funnel, middle, bottom of the funnel, and post purchase. I included products pages here because those are also very important. I hope that is useful. Bye-bye.